Hi, I'm Vanessa, and here's a quick butterfly tutorial. So I used a homemade split cake, DFX white half angle brush, round number 4, and a sponge. So I loaded up my sponge with most of the colors. I try not to get too much white on there, but if it happens to get on, it's fine. I pinched the corner so it makes it easier to get into the corner of the eye. So I'll start off by sponging from the inner corner of the eye while I'm pinching my sponge. And I'm really just trying to get that yellow in the corner, and then I'll bring up the yellow and orange a little further up just so that I'm making sure that all the colors are coming through. And I pat while I sponge just so that I can get that nice blend. And the shape that I get from the sponge is just really thin to thick. It's thin in the corner of the eye, and then it gradually gets thicker. Okay, so this is my favorite part. This is a half angle shader brush, and I can load it like a flat brush, but get the double looking loaded teardrops that I'm not good at. And I can still use the same brush to do the outside design of the butterfly, which is nice because I'm not changing brushes, I'm just using the same one. And you can always change the different colors with whatever design you're doing. Okay, so I'm going to use the half angle shader brush. It's loaded with the white and blue, white on top. And I'll start off with a teardrop and then go back in and do a wiggle, wiggle, flick. And then again, teardrop, wiggle, wiggle, flick. And for the bottom of the butterfly's wing, I just use teardrops. And I absolutely love this because I don't have to go in with a sponge underneath the eye. And you can always change the shape of the butterfly's wings by how many teardrops you use. Short, long, fat, thin, and my favorite part is that I can use the same brush to do all of it. So I'm still using the same brush, the half angle shader. It's loaded with the white and blue, and I'm just adding 2 teardrops to the top of the butterfly, and I'll use the same brush to add the body and the antennas, which is pretty much teardrops. So again, you can always change the shape of the design just by how many you use and how you use them, whether you want to use thick or thin teardrops, it's up to you. Okay, now I'm using my round number 4 brush. I have it loaded with DFX white, and I'm just randomly painting dots on the butterfly's wing, just underneath her eye, the corner of her eyes, and then I'll do the same thing on the other side. With the same brush, I'll just randomly add Starburst. And after this, I would normally add glitter, but my daughter does not like glitter anymore. I think I've worn her out with glitter. So that's it. You just add a little glitter and you're done. So here's the finished look. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you all enjoyed it. If you'd like to see more of my work, you can go to www.colormefacepainting.com.